11 o'clock. Let's try this as well. Oh, good morning, you two. You're right on time. I was just checking my appointments. Yes, it's a lovely day. Sure, you can put your things there. Have a seat right here. Very good. So, if you had some time to review the literature that I gave you and have some family discussions. Good. All right, well, let's get to it then. I just want to reassure you that we don't have to make every single decision today, but we do need to make some of the significant ones that affect how our building crew will prepare the building site. So we can do as much or as little as you're interested in doing today. But we'll do the important stuff first. So let me see. I've got a file on you. Just type up our discussion, the major decisions that you're making. Is a bit crowded. So 11 and 23. So we had these two corner lots. 81. See, I'm trying to read this upside down. 81, another corner lot. 71. This is the middle lot, but it's up on a little hill and gives a great view of the neighborhood. And 52. Here we go, another corner lot. So it looks like we had all corner lots except for this one. What did you end up thinking about those five? Mm-hmm. So we're ruling out 71, which means you are going to be living on a corner lot. The question is, which one? So you're looking for something a bit closer to the lake, but not in the flood zone. So that's going to give you probably 23, and because 11 is further north, and 81 here, and 52 here. I agree. This one gives you many advantages. Very close to the lake, above the flood zone, corner lot, larger corner lot, and then the wooded area that will remain undeveloped here gives you a lot of wooded privacy. It's a fantastic location in this development. So you're going to go with 23. Excellent. All right. And then we looked at four home styles: the Nipawin, the Rundle, the Cape Cod, and our RTM, that's our modular building option. So let me fold up this map. We'll keep that open in case we need to glance at it. Okay, so let me find our homes. Here we go. So, as you'll recall, the Nipawin gave you two roof styles, the gable and the hip roof, and we had a variety of layouts with minor changes. We have the Rundle, which is right here. This one gave us two options, the 28 by 40 and the 28 by 48. So if you want to stick with the three bedrooms that we discussed earlier, then the 28 by 40 model would be your choice. Then Cape Cod, right next door. Room upstairs with the children's bedroom, or having your bedroom and the children's bedroom upstairs and the recreation room off to the side of the living room. And then we had our RTM. Oh, okay, so you're not interested in that one. Okay. So have you made a decision? Okay. So you've discussed this with your bank. Okay, that's very good news. So we're going to go with the larger home at 28 by 48. We're going to go with the hip roof, and that's going to give you one of these two layouts, which we can make decisions about later. But really it has to do with the flow between the living room and the dining room. Very good. I'm certainly a fan of your choice. So we're going with the Rundle, which is actually going to give you four bedrooms. One master, one or two for the kids, a rec room, possible guest room. You've got lots of options here. Okay, so I need to do some paperwork to get things started. And let's see if I can fold this again. Going with okay. And I knew I folded up that map too soon. We need to determine the address. at the corner of Palisade and Spinel. Now, here's an interesting proposition for you. You are actually going to be able to determine your own address. And what I mean by that is, it depends on how you have your house situated on the lot. If you situate it this way, with the front facing Palisade, then your address is going to be on Palisade Avenue. If you situate it this way, facing Spinel Street, then your address is going to be on Spinel Street. You've already discussed this? Okay. That's probably a smart decision. Although I love the name Palisade Avenue, situating it to face Spinel is going to give you this large backyard, a patio area that will have a view of this undeveloped vista. Whereas if it's situated the other way, you're only going to get that view out of the front windows. So that's probably very smart. So we're going with Spinel Street. Make a few decisions today about building specifications. One thing that we need to do is place orders for supplies at particular times in the building schedule. And one of those important decisions has to do with your roof, because as soon as the frame goes up, the roof goes on. So I want to discuss with you three of our Sydney Duroid products. We have three shingle options. We've got the 210 roof shingles, and those butt up against one another, but it does offer double coverage over the entire roof. We also have the 210 roof shingles, and these are unique because they are actually interlocking. So it's single coverage, but for high wind areas, this is a good option because you're not going to get any of that peeling because of the interlocking mechanism. And then our third option is the low slope 235 shingles. This is actually triple coverage, and they are designed to withstand more water pressure on the roof, and that's because of the slope. In a steep slope home, the water will shed quickly, snow will shed quickly, but in a low slope home, the elements will linger. So this is a good option, particularly for the home style that you've selected, with the low slope roof and the hip roof on the side. We'll go with the low slope 235. Let's see what the other more urgent decisions that we need to make. Windows and doors at our next appointment. think that's all we need to decide at this point. We have some fun stuff coming up soon. But we need to get things under roof before we get to this stage. Mind giving me your phone number. I do have it in my records, but okay. All right. And this is going to be our draft for now. Go ahead and set up an appointment . What I'm going to do is share these specs with our architect, and they will create some final drawings for your approval before we sign off and get started . Right. So, we do need to schedule a couple of weeks out from today, so I have an opportunity to speak with the architect. So, we're probably looking middle of June. Is there a particular day of the week that works for you? So Fridays are good. Okay. Let's shoot for Friday, June 18th. And at this point, my schedule is open for that. that day, what time would you like to meet? And 11 a.m. is a good time, okay. That seems to be our favorite rendezvous time. And I need to discuss Wilson specs with architect. Okay. Excellent. It's becoming more real, isn't it? Wait till they put the shovel in the ground. Then it'll be real. Okay. You all have a wonderful afternoon. If you have any questions in the meantime, don't hesitate to give me a call. But otherwise, I'll see you in June.